Thank you guys for tuning in to another exciting episode of Allow Me to Retort. This week, I've got some interesting stories, so let's just go over them really quickly. We're going to be talking about gay rapper Lil Nas X being gay, non-homosexual rappers line up to support President Donald Trump, the UK sucks at handling COVID-19, and the Trump train escorts Kamala Harris out of Texas. That's why you don't mess with them. I'm Anthony, and this is Allow Me to Retort. Thank you guys again for tuning in. Don't forget to leave a comment down below, like and subscribe if you're digging the videos. I don't upload videos on a very set schedule, so you want to ring that bell as well, because that way you get notified when I do publish something. And remember, this is news. News changes quickly and you want to be informed when it happens. Let's just jump into the first story today. I've got Lil Nas X slamming criticism of his Nicki Minaj Halloween costume. Now, when I first read this headline, I thought I read it as in Nicki Minaj was being criticized for something outlandish and disgusting that she wore. And then I scrolled down and I saw this and I was already disgusted. I was like, look at her. That's nasty. Look at how she dresses. This is a female being supposed to be a role model for our kids. And she just, it just grosses me out. Like, I got the heebie-jeebies. But then as I scrolled down more and continued to read the article, I realized this isn't Nicki Minaj. This is Old Town Road singing guy Lil Nas X. That's a man dressed like that.
I've got an idea.
Why on earth did you hit that woman?
Right, let me show you, baby. That ain't no woman. It's a man, man. It's one of Dr. Evil's assassins.
That's a man dressed like that. This guy did songs with Tim McGraw. This is the guy who your kids are being influenced by. He's hot on, what is it, TikTok and Instagram and all that. And this is what they're, you know, young black kids are supposed to be looking up to. It's bad enough that this is actually how Nicki Minaj dresses. They say that his outfit was inspired by what she actually wore in one of her music videos. So it's bad enough that young black women have to look up to other young black women who have nothing to offer the world besides their physical assets. But now young black boys are going to look up to this young black man who's made a name for himself, and he's got even less to offer to the world. I don't even know what to say about. I mean, it's gross. It's literally the most gross thing I've ever seen. I almost threw up when I thought it was Nicki Minaj, and then I learned that this was Lil Nas X, who, by the way, if you're into rap or anything like that, you know who Nas is. Nas is one of the greatest, most influential hip-hop artists of all time. He's done great things. His music is inspirational. His lyrics are complicated on a way that most rappers don't ever even reach the way he plays with words. And so for this young guy to come up and even take Nas's name and throw it in the middle of his bull crap, and this is how he's dressing, this is this generation's Nas. Al Nas was taking on Jay-Z and breaking down barriers and making inspirational songs, you know, I know I can be what I want to be, all that stuff like that.
Listen up, you can be anything in the world, and God we trust, an architect, doctor, maybe an actress, but nothing comes easy, it takes much practice.
This Nas is, I don't even know what to say about it. It's just gross, it's just nasty, and this is news that, you know, USA Today decided to cover, or Today News, whatever they are, decided to cover, because apparently he's getting backlash, as he should, for dressing like whatever that is. Speaking of rappers, straight rappers have lined up and come out to support Donald Trump in droves. I mean, in this article alone, they mentioned Lil Wayne, they mentioned Ice Cube, they mentioned 50 Cent. There was one guy, I can't remember his name, but he had the rainbow colored hair. Apparently Waka Dog across the street has also endorsed Donald Trump, saying that he was better than Obama, which kind of broke the internet as well. So Trump's got smart black support. You know, some of these rappers, not all of them, the rainbow hair guy and Walk of Flame, whatever, those guys, I'm not so sure they're the brightest people ever, but some of these people, Ice Cube and 50 Cent, Lil Wayne as well, these guys have been doing the rap thing for so long that they realize that there's more to life than being thugs and promoting thug culture. These guys have started businesses, clothing lines, you know, they found a way, and a lot of them, 50 Cent and Lil Wayne, I know, contribute back to the community. As a matter of fact, Ice Cube does as well. So these are people who have taken that money and now, instead of just constantly promoting this foolishness and this coon life culture, they've come up and now they are using their power and their money and their influence to better the world. And they're noticing that if they want to do that, they're going to have to work with Donald Trump. And they're trying to bring this country together, and I'm all for that. But this is all coming behind the announcement of the Platinum Plan. You know, Lil Wayne said that he looked at it and that he's very excited, and he thinks that Trump is really trying to help the black community out. Ice Cube is also saying that he looked at it and he's working with whoever is going to help. You know, he stopped short of actually endorsing Donald Trump, but he said he's working with whoever is willing to work with the black community. And if you remember from last week, I talked about, or maybe it's the week before, Ice Cube reached out to both parties. Joe Biden's party said, great stuff, we'll talk to you later. Trump's party said, awesome, come in, let's talk about it right now. And so that's why Ice Cube is working with Donald Trump, because these are the people who want to get things done. Donald Trump is constantly working to improve his appearance with the black community, because the media is constantly trying to paint him as a racist, as somebody who's endorsed white supremacy, when he has never done any of those things. So Donald Trump is working double hard to win the vote of the black people. He wants to win our trust, and it's about time that we give it to him, because remember, he's been doing this for 4 years. Joe Biden's been doing it for 47 years, and Joe Biden's done nothing to help us. Not just black people, but Americans in general. Joe Biden and his family have themselves interest at heart. That's all they do. They're career politicians. They make money off of mine and your tax dollars. Donald Trump has forfeited his salary. Donald Trump has been losing money since he's become the president of the United States. So just keep that in mind when you go up to vote. You've got, what, 2 days left to cast your vote? If there's anybody who's on the fence, just remember that Donald Trump has only been doing this for 4 years, and he indeed has done more to help the black community. He's got black rapper support like that of Obama at this point. He's got huge names, Lil Wayne, Ice Cube, 50 Cent, Waka Flocka. These guys are big names in the rap community, and they're coming out and supporting Donald Trump. Just like they probably, some of them may have and may have not endorsed Barack Obama, but these are huge numbers. These are huge, important people in apparently the black community. And who did Joe Biden get? He got Cardi B to endorse him. And an endorsement by Cardi B is not really a positive endorsement at all. She's still doing the old thing. She's still in that stage where she's promoting the foolishness and the coonery and the disrespect towards women. She's a gross woman. She's a shame and a bad mark on the name of black women everywhere across the globe. And so that's Cardi B. That's who endorses Joe Biden. But you've got people who have come up. These people wear suits to work now. The people who Donald Trump is rubbing shoulders with, Lil Wayne and Ice Cube and 50 Cent, these are people who have made business. They are businessmen. They are entrepreneurs. And they are beacons of hope in the black community, because they've come from the struggle and now they're promoting the success and trying to educate people on how to reach success. Meanwhile, Cardi B is talking about she's got a WAP. In other news across the pond, the UK is having some woes with the coronavirus, and I'll give you a little bit more in the next section, but they have apparently lost 16,000 cases of corona. They've lost the data of tracking people. So they had been using an Excel spreadsheet to track people. They ran into some weird software issue where apparently the numbers only went up to a certain amount, and then they were entering these numbers, and then all of the other stuff got deleted when it got converted. Let's see if I can make that into some more layman's terms. So basically, from reading this, the gist of it is two different firms had been tracking coronavirus data, and they each together probably had like over a million rows of data, and they exported that, and then they gave it over to these guys, and apparently they were using a very old 2007 version of Microsoft Excel, which could only hold about 65,000 rows of data. So when these two companies got together and they used this tool to import these files, whatever wouldn't fit was just lost, which is completely crazy. It just shows how dumb government is, no matter whether it's over here in the United States or across the pond. You would think that they would say, hey, we should back this up when we convert it. We shouldn't just convert it and hit delete on the original files. It's amazing to hear that this 16,000 rows of data or 16,000 cases of corona are just lost in the air. Nobody has any way. Like, you mean to make the companies that recorded the data don't still have it somewhere? And then when they handed that data over to the government put it together. They didn't think, hey, we should make a copy of these people's data. If somebody working with one flash drive on one computer combined everything, and now it's lost. And if you want to talk bad about Trump's handling of the coronavirus, this administration's handling the coronavirus, I haven't heard that we lost 16,000 cases of coronavirus. I think the people who have it, we know who they are because we've been doing more testing than everybody else. And, you know, we also aren't tracking our people, at least not publicly knowledge yet. We're not tracking people to the way that some of these other countries are doing overseas, which is a good thing. Tracking people always ends badly. We shouldn't be signing up for this kind of thing. But speaking of the UK, Boris Johnson, the prime minister over there, has decided to lock down England because the science is saying that numbers over there are growing. It's getting out of control. Saturday, they have announced that the UK's COVID cases have reached 1 million and its death toll is over 46,000 deaths from COVID-19. So obviously they're having some big trouble handling the pandemic themselves. It is not the UK's fault, however. It is obviously China's fault. This is where it started from. They are the epicenter of it, and they did not keep it from spreading to the rest of the world, and they lied and hid information from the rest of the world when it was pertinent. These leaders around the world are dealing with it the best they can. However, you'll see the news and the media slam our president like he's the only one who's struggling with it, when this is something unprecedented. This is something that we have not seen before in the world, like a pandemic like this, not in this age where people are traveling so much, at least. You know, there were plagues and other huge pandemics that wreaked havoc on the world, but in this age, in 2020, people are traveling and spreading and coming in contact with people more than ever. So, of course, this pandemic is a brand new thing. We haven't been able to adapt and deal with it. And you're seeing that all around the world. Over in London, UK, Boris Johnson is shutting his country down again because they have not been able to handle COVID-19. And Trump is doing a great job at handling it because our death toll is going down. Yes, the numbers of people who are getting it are increasing, but because we have that, people are learning to deal with it. We're testing out new medicines on the people who are getting it. People are coming back better than they've ever been before. And this just goes to show two different ways that you can handle it. He's freaking out. He's going to lock his country down. I think that you'll see the death toll continue to rise when you start shutting people down, keeping them in their homes. And I hope over here in the United States, I believe that we're going to see the death toll continue to lower. Maybe the amount of people who get the virus will continue to rise, but that is not what's important. What's important is getting the virus, not having any permanent long-lasting effects, and surviving it. And that's what we're seeing happening over here in the United States. People aren't talking about that. They just like to throw the number of people getting it in your face and freak you out like these are the same amount of people who are dying. No, the number of people who have COVID-19 or have contracted COVID-19 is enormous. There's no lie about that. But the amount of people who have died from it is relatively small. All deaths matter, but it is relatively small in the grand scheme of things. And that is what the media should be telling us instead of fear-mongering like Joe Biden does and telling us we're heading for a dark winter. And in my last beautiful, wonderful story, speaking of Joe Biden, a bus that I believe has been confirmed to have Kamala Harris on it was escorted right on out of Texas. Some patriots, some Trump supporters, I believe it was about 12 or 15 cars, were waiting on a bridge.
This bus, funniest thing I've ever seen, man. They're like chasing them. This is in New Braunfels right now. And they're like, they got, look at this. They're like literally escorting about a town on a Trump flag. Oh my God, this is the funniest thing I've ever seen.
They surrounded the Kamala Harris bus and just rode alongside it and followed it to its rally. And actually, Kamala Harris and the people on board got so afraid that they ended up canceling several rallies and several stops in Texas that day. Now, I'm not saying that I endorse these kind of fear tactics. You know, I don't know if that was the goal, was to intimidate and to scare these people out of Texas, but that's what happened. And overall, I say that's a net win for Texas. You got rid of Sleepy Joe's bus, and you've got rid of skeezy Kamala Harris, and your patriot showed up to ride. And I think that is why Texas is one of, has always been one of the greatest states in America. And I will stand by Texas. And if Trump loses, I'm probably going to try to find my way to Texas, because that'll probably be the last place to fall. I don't care about Houston and Dallas. They can say whatever they want to. They can start to trim blue all they want to, but they are outnumbered. I guarantee you, we will show up in Texas. Patriots will show up. And if we need to, we will annex the South, starting with Texas. We'll make Texas the capital of the South, and we won't take no more BS. But this is amazing, the amount of people who will go out of their way to support this president. I really believe that you will see some kind of uprising if this election does not go the way that the American people really want it to be. There's one group of Americans who want everything handed to them, and they're going to vote for the president who's going to just hand them everything for free. But at the same time, they're the ones who won't actually take any action. They won't stand up and fight for that president. There's another group of Americans who will fight for whatever it is they want. They want to earn their way in this country. They want to earn their freedoms, and they will fight for their freedoms, and they will take action if they feel wronged. So you've got a bunch of lazy Biden supporters on one side, and you've got a bunch of active, ambitious, dedicated Trump supporters on the other side. And that laziness, it just might get Joe Biden elected. But I'm telling you, you're going to see some division like you've never seen it before if Joe Biden gets in office. That's scary, and I hope it doesn't come to that, but that's just what I believe may happen. But what do you guys think? Do you think it's gross that rapper Lil Nas X dressed as Nicki Minaj for Halloween, and this is who young black men have to look up to as a role model, as a success story? Do you think it's amazing that non-gay rappers are coming out in droves to support this current president and say that he's doing right by black America, trying to influence the people who follow them? Do you think it's true that the UK sucks at handling the coronavirus, and that it's not just America who's having problems with it, and of course the media paints it as this president bad, orange man source of all your problems, but clearly China source of all of our problems at this moment, and the Trump train escorting Kamala Harris out of Texas? It's pretty cool, right? I'm Anthony, and this is Allow Me to Retort.